suppose in the evenings it can be. You can see a little bit of that in the evenings where it's a little bit inappropriate.
Living life like this, gotta paint a picture when I write like this. Tales from my hood, not a sight like this. Where they up to no good on a night like this. And they murder motherfuckers just cuz. Type of shit I seen, you probably wonder what I was. I was in the crib just sitting on a rug. Bases coming through looking for the plug. Now, born and raised in my area. Beautiful by day, by night, it's hysteria. Fuck around and bury it at night. Riding with my homies on sight. Mama tell me to come in at night. Now I really gotta go, but they never know. Living life to the fullest, I gotta blow. Po-po, finna bust in the dough. We got blow in the crib, in the kitchen over there. Instead of the baby with the bib, goddamn. Feel like.
But when it's just people just doing things like behind where on the wall there, where it's just a scribble on the wall,
yeah.
I just think, what's the point?
Stop, but they even call the cops. Do it for the money and the bitches and the drugs and the props. Tell me why another body even got a drop. Get shot off top for some shit that was gang related.
What do you think about the young people's style today?
Being quite odd looking.
World, there is a lot of different cultures, subcultures and styles, especially in the city Manchester we are in right now.
Each city has their own style.
Yeah.
And even though there's a lot of different styles, it all works together. It's very mixed, it's really nice.
There's a lot of judges about us team being rebellious. Mostly the street culture is the target. But is it all true? That is why we have talked with a lot of different peoples to hear about their opinion and how the street culture is here in Manchester.
I think teens get a hard time by adults. I think, you know, everyone likes to party and stuff, so I think the best way to do that is express yourself in art and music and do something positive.
How would you describe the teens today?
Pretty driven.
I think
everyone wants to do something positive. And everyone wants to see something good because there's a lot of bad politics at the moment.
Yeah.
And I think a lot of young people realise that now.
Yeah.
So I think a lot of people want to do good things.
What do you think about the street culture here in Manchester?
It's really good. This shop Cow's the main hub for vintage clothing in Manchester. There's a cool street right there. Yeah. It's very diverse. It's mixed. It ranges mainly from 90s.
Yeah.
Right back to 1960s.
Yeah.
With flares and fringe jackets, so there's a big range of.
Most of the time, like the main customers are probably like early to late teens, and then. We do quite a lot of women's clothes, so it's a lot of young girls. And then I think maybe like men in their early 20s for a lot of the sport kind of clothes and shirts and stuff we sell as well. People seem to be really into sporty clothes now. People are buying like rain jackets and stuff as a fashion statement rather than as a practicality, and like Patagonia and things like that. We don't really sell that, but that's kind of become a really big trend because of like grime culture and, you know, a few other things like that. There's, you know, athletic clothing become really popular again. It's quite 90s influence, I'd say. And then we've got a lot of the like decoration is pretty kind of broad, is all kind of older stuff, like 70s stuff, 60s stuff.
What are you interested in?
Music. Psychedelic music, rock music, and a mixture of all sorts, really.
Music and art and my crafting. I like music. I'm photography. I like music and art and politics.
What do you think about all the debates there is about us teams being rebellious?
I don't know. I think it's just easy when people find it easy to stereotype instead of actually knowing people, and I don't think that's true at all. I would say underappreciated, and I think that a lot of us are quite intelligent now, but you don't really see that.
What do you think about the street culture here in Manchester? Can you describe it?
Yeah, particularly in this part of Manchester, so like the northern quarter and all this, it's quite individual and colourful and yeah, it's quite vibrant.
How would you describe the teens today?
They're all very different, but I think we're all like similar in some ways, like the way we act, but then like the way we dress and show ourselves.
What is the fashion today here in Manchester?
It's very unique, it's very out there, but yeah, it's a lot of colour and everyone's got like their own personal style, so yeah. I think it's all very different, like everyone wears different stuff, it just depends on who you are as a person.
I think it's all quite different. And like everyone has their own sort of individuality.
Can you describe the street culture in three words?
It's really retro now, or like 90s stuff. It's really versatile as well, everyone's different. It's good.
It's quite a lot of colourful stuff, isn't it? It's like quite vibrant, energetic, youthful.
I think it's very interesting, there's a lot that seems to be going on.
Lively, amazing, and class.
Yeah, quite independent. There's a lot of variety.
We get people of all ages, really, so we get like young kids coming in and buying skateboards, and we get adults coming in and buying skateboards, so like we cover a wide range of age groups, really. We're a skateboarding shop, so like all of the brands that we sell in our shop are skateboarding companies, so like the stuff that we sell is almost entirely skateboarding companies. Well, it varies a little bit, like some people like wearing really baggy clothing and like they associate that with skateboarding, but like in the 90s everyone was wearing like the baggiest things, in the 80s people were dressing like punks, and like now people are wearing like slimmer fitting things, so it's changed a lot over the years.
But I suppose it's always like age old debate that's always been going on, isn't it, really? I think it's important for young people to rebel.
Yeah.
Definitely, yeah.
Well, skateboarding itself, it's got a particular kind of style that's been around for years and years, and like it's got a very like definitive image, I think. So yeah, it's just influenced by skateboarding culture.
I suppose it's always been a little bit like that anyway, like stuff in fashion or the mainstream, like taking little bits from what it sees as counterculture, whether it be skating or certain styles of music and stuff like that. I suppose that stuff's always kind of gone on, really. Well, it's like part of the mainstream.
Street culture comes and goes. As new generations come, new cultures start, new cultures end, new cultures start. It's an ongoing cycle. It's an ongoing cycle. Cultures.